This time I made a hard rule shortcut to mute your mic right away during a Zoom meeting. Actually, it's not something I will use, but my wife told me she needs this, so I try to make it with what I have. USB native function of ESP32-S2 or S3 makes it easy to create USBHID. Since ESP32 can be connected as a generic USB keyboard, there is no need to install any extra driver or program. This is really important. If something needs to be installed, it's very annoying. Pressing this 60mm arcade button will trigger a pre-programmed action. Let me show you how I made this. Actually, the point of this project is this arcade button. If you go to arcade, you will see these buttons used on many arcade machines. I've been waiting to do a project with this kind of button for a long time. I think this is a perfect project for these big buttons. So I immediately purchased a 60mm arcade button. I bought it for about $1 each through the Chinese open market. It's basically a button used in arcade machines, so it is not a 0.1 inch 2.54 millimeter pin connector that we commonly use in Arduino. However, there seems to be no problem in using it. If we press the button from the top, this white part comes down. This closes the circuit of the switch and allows a current flow. These are the parts that make up one button, and one LED goes into it. If you want to always turn on the LED, you can connect VCC and ground to both ends. But I will light the LED only when the button is pressed. Here is the micro switch. The switch contacts are normally open. When the button is pressed, the contacts close. Let me show you how to assemble it. This part has to fit tight. Now all you have to do is put the completed module into the button. It's very simple. If you look here, you can see when the button is pressed, the switch is also pressed by it. This is how arcade buttons work. When fixing it in the enclosure later, use this nut to make it tightly. It is connected to ESP32-S3. You need to use a board that supports a native USB interface. ESP32-S2 works the same. As you can see here, I made it very roughly. I put it in the box, so I believe it's okay. The work for the button is the same as the button we normally use. Just I attached a 10K register to the signal pin. When the switch is pressed, current flows from 5V to GPIO5 and high is input. Otherwise, the switch drops and current flows to ground and low is input to GPIO5. You can easily see on the right screen how I wired it up. This program is based on Espressif's TinyUSB example. If you want to review the original example source code, please try the TUSBHID in ESPIDF example. There is a similar example in the ESP Arduino course, so you can try both of them. Here is the starting point. First is adding an interrupt for the hardware button. After that, initialize TinyUSB. My code is also very simple. Since everything related to the USB connection is handled by TinyUSB, all I need to do is to check when a button is pressed and report a specific key to the connected host. That's all what I need. If the button is pressed, it reports the ART key and A key. After 50 milliseconds, it reports back that all keys have been released. That's what this program is all about, and it's made very simple. To reduce debouncing on the button, I set the button's filter time to 100 milliseconds and also made the button can be pressed only 3 times per second. Also, I didn't forget the 10K ohm register. I temporarily used the paper box at home, which doesn't seem too bad. You can make it better. I used the nut under the arcade button, so it was tightly fixed. My ESP32 board is not yet fixed inside. After testing, if all good, seems like I need to attach the board inside the box. Too rattling now. I usually use a USB breakout board when doing native USB projects, but this time I used a built-in USB port. If your board supports USB native interface but doesn't have a USB port, you can use the same by connecting GPIO 19 and 20 to USB data. This way, Zoom micrometer is completed. The PC has the same effect as receiving user input from the normal keyboard. In the Windows version of Zoom, Alt-A is a shortcut for audio mute. If you are a Mac user, you can change it to Command-Shift-A. Not only Zoom, but all the hotkeys you want can be made into these hardware buttons. Hardware production is simple, it can be implemented very simple in the code. And also this source code can be downloaded through my GitHub page. I think that's all for this project. If you have any questions about this project, please leave them in the comments below. Alright, thanks for watching, see you on the next project.